Coming up, we look at the fastest and largest memory-optimized virtual machines in the cloud with the availability of 6 TB and 12 TB Mv2 VMs in Azure, ideal for running SAP HANA and large-scale business-critical workloads. With the Mv2 Series based on Intel Xeon Platinum processors, you can now create virtual machines with up to 416 virtual cores and 12 TB RAM on demand, offering simplified management through the Azure portal. Combined with Azure Premium Storage and Write Accelerator, you can achieve sub-millisecond write performance for your SAP HANA database transactions. Until now, for on-premises infrastructure at this scale, you had to run on bare metal, which you would end up having to maintain yourself. This often resulted in paying for idle or underutilized hardware in your data center. Using Mv2 VMs, large-scale SAP HANA deployments can take advantage of being able to scale easily from 3 TB all the way up to 12 TB or scale down seamlessly to meet your business needs. This also increases your agility. You can speed up SAP release cycles by spinning up dev test systems in minutes and pay only for what you use. Let's put it to the test. Here, I have a Mv2 VM running SAP HANA with 3 TB of memory that you can see in the Azure portal. Now, let's look at our HANA database in HANA Studio. I can see the database memory size here, along with the status. So now I'm going to show you how to easily scale up this environment to keep up with the demand. First, we'll gracefully shut down the database, resize the virtual machine, and then bring the database back online. Starting in HANA Studio, I will right-click on the database, select Configuration and Monitoring, and Stop System. Now, that will shut down HANA. Let's go back to our VM in the Azure portal and select the Size tab. And here, you can see that there are 3, 6, and 12 TB options with up to 416 cores. Let's choose the 12 TB or 11,400 gigabytes option and click Resize. This will reboot the virtual machine with the increased memory size. Usually, you would do this during a defined maintenance window in off-peak hours. You could also accomplish this with zero downtime in a HA environment by resizing your secondary VM, failing over to it, and then resizing your primary. Now our resizing is complete. And in our case, in reality, it took around 10 minutes, and we can see that our VM now has 12 TB of memory. Let's use HANA Studio and bring HANA database back online. I'll perform the reverse steps of what you saw earlier and click Restart System. And in a moment, you will see that everything is back up and running successfully in our 12 TB VM. I just showed you scaling up, but you can also scale down just as easily. Back in the Azure portal, I'll scale the VM down to 6 TB. And in roughly the same amount of time, it'll resize the virtual machine seamlessly. Now, beyond scalability, these mission-critical environments also need to be designed for high availability. One of the ways you can increase availability of your system is by leveraging Azure Availability Zones. This works by running a primary and a secondary replica of your instance in 2 different Azure data centers within the same Azure region. This means if anything happens to the data center with the primary instance, services will continue to run via the secondary instance without incurring downtime and reaching 99.99% availability. Let me show you how this works. As you can see here, I have 2 Mv2 virtual machines, HANA 1 and HANA 2, running a clustered HANA database. HANA 1 is currently primary, HANA 2 is the secondary. Each are running in different Azure zones within the same region. In HANA Studio, if I click into the landscape, I can also see HANA 1 and HANA 2. Before I force a failover event, I'll open SAP GUI and begin a SAP user transaction. I'm going to change this user's first and last name without committing the change. Here, We want to show that this is available after we have failed over to the secondary. So I'll minimize the window, get to my script on the desktop, and run it. This will force the failover from HANA 1 to HANA 2. And in just a moment, you'll see it has failed over successfully. As proof, in SAP HANA Studio, we'll see HANA 2 is now the primary and is running successfully. So let's go back to our SAP GUI. I can see my transaction and I'll hit save. Because the session persists, the transaction completed successfully. I've shown you how you can seamlessly scale up SAP HANA databases on Azure Mv2 VMs and also architect highly available database clusters with near zero downtime for business continuity. If you're an SAP customer, check out our certifications at aka.ms/sapcert, and you can start using it today. To learn more, check out azure.com/sap and github.com/sap HANA. Thanks for watching.